This video, we are going to be doing two examples. First of all, it's going to practice the skill of substituting and being mindful of our signs. But what I'm really trying to do with this is we want to land up, the endpoint that we want to land up is we want to represent our linear function as a straight line graph on the Cartesian plane. But we need to just take a step back and look at some of the prior knowledge that we have. We are going to go back to our spider diagram, connect that to our table, connect that to our function, our equation that was given there. And I'm going to show you that they all are just basically talking about the same thing. So let's just quickly go back to a spider diagram. So with your spider diagram, we've got an input. We put a value in. And then we get an output. It spits out a value for us. Now, if we use this equation to complete our spider diagram, what does it say? There's our input value, which will be our x. And then we get our output value y. So it is saying we have to take our input value of x and we need to times that by 3. So we take our input value, whatever it is, we're going to times it by 3. And then we have to take 2 away, and then that will give us our output value. So in this case, if we put in a negative 2, let's see what we will get out. What will our y value be? So it will be negative 2 times 3, which is negative 6. Take 2 more away, and that must be negative 8. Okay, perfect. Let's put in I'm not going to do all of them. Let's put the 0 in there. 0 times 3 is just 0. And if I take 2 away, that will give me negative 2. And then if we put in a positive 2, I times that by 3, that gives me 6. And if I take 2 away, that will give me 4. Okay, and there is our spider diagram. Now we are just going to use our equation to do that. And that is more what you can expect to do in grade 9 and beyond. All right, so our input value there, we started by using x as 2, and then we saw we got our y value out as negative 8. So we're going to do that again. We're going to say, okay, if our x is negative 2, y is equal to 3 times negative 2 and take 2 away, what is that equal to? It will be negative 8. There we go. We get exactly the same answer because we're doing the same thing. Instead of just using our spider diagram, we are just using our equation. Let's go substitute. Now we have to do all of them. So let's go substitute minus 1. In the place of x, I'm going to substitute a negative 1. Those two are being multiplied. Since they are being multiplied in the equation, they must be multiplied when we substitute a value for x. Take 2 away. Then my output value will be negative 5. Let's just double check that. That would be negative 3. Take 2 more away. Yes. Okay. Got it. Now, y is equal to where my x is 0. Let's see what the y will be equal to. I substitute that 0 in. 3 times 0 is 0, and I take 2 away will give us negative 2. And that is exactly what we got with our spider diagram. Let's substitute 1. What will the output value y be if I substitute in the place of x a 1 and I take 2 away? My y will then be 1. So my y will then be 1. Last one. What will my y be when my x is 2? So I'm multiplying them. And I subtract 2, that will be equal to 6, take away 2, which would be 4, which was exactly what we got in our spider diagram over there. Okay, so now our table is complete. We just did substitution, but now we need to think Cartesian plane. We just found 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points that we will be able to plot on the Cartesian plane. Look what I mean there. When my x is negative 2, my y is negative 8. When my x is negative 1, my y is negative 5. When my x is 0, then my y will be negative 2. When my x is 1, my y will be 1. When my x is 2, my y will be 4. We can go plot those 5 points, and I'm telling you that that will then give us a straight line. But we're going to look into that in more detail later, and then I'll show you how I knew that. Maybe you can already see how I knew that. Okay, second example. I'm not going to draw a spider diagram for this one. I'm just going to go straight to using my equation and completing my table. I've got my input value there of x, and then I've got my output value there of y. But do you see how this one is slightly different? With the previous one, we were given all the input values and we just had to find the output values. Now with this one, we actually have input values and output values. So let's just see how we're going to deal with that. All right, let's start at the beginning. If I plug into the place of x, let me just warn you against this there, that negative over there, it's a negative one coefficient. We just don't write it, but remember that it is there, that we don't mess up the signs with this one. So it would be negative one, and then we times that if our x is negative two, and then I subtract two. There is my equation with substituting x as negative two. You don't have to write that one there, but I mean, that is what it means. It means that there is a coefficient of negative one. So that will give us a positive two. And I take away 2, so that will be 0. When my x is negative 2, my y will be 0. And that is the coordinate that we can go plot on the Cartesian plane. Now let's look at the second one. There we do not have the x value, we have the y value. So we have to go plug that into the place of y of our function. So in the place of y, there will be a 1 equal to negative x minus 2. Now, it is a simple equation that we need to solve. There's not just one way of doing this. You can decide how you're going to go about this. I think I'm going to do that. Yeah, that should be fine. I get that x is equal to negative 3. However you decide you do that, make sure that you get to x is equal to negative 3. Perfect. Let me make the ones that we complete orange. Okay, the third one. Now we have our input value again. So what will our output value y be when my input value of x is 0 and I take 2 away? Well, that will be equal to negative 2. Negative 2. Next one, second to last. I think the fancy English word for second to last is penultimate. I learned that word the other day. And maybe you can use that in your English. All right, so the output value where we were given with the penultimate one. So in my place of y, I'm then going to substitute 4 is equal to negative x and then minus 2. That will give me x, and take 4 away. X is equal to negative 6. And then with the last one, there I can plug in my input value as 10. What will my output be if my input, I'm just writing the one there, you don't have to, if my input is 10. That would give me negative 10, take 2 away, which will be negative 12. And there our table is complete. And again, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 coordinate pairs that we will be able to plot.